Okay, ready? So, today, we're gonna take the stuff that's in those boxes, and we're going to build a nuclear fusion reactor. In Simone's workshop, how would you introduce yourself?
I don't know. Person who makes things and has a lot of tools and a place we can mess up.
And this is David. David's the reason we can actually do this, because Simone and I don't know what we're doing here.
Talk about yourself.
Yeah. David runs a real kind of nuclear fusion. They're building massive devices that could, in the future, create electricity that people could actually use.
But today, we're going to be building a fusor, which is not commercial scale. It's much smaller. But if we're successful, we'll be able to build this system today, get it running, and do fusion.
In my backyard! Woo!
In fusion, what we're doing is we're taking two particles and at very high energies, we're forcing them together where they fuse and form a heavier particle, but that takes high energies to do. So we'll be using high voltage today. So it's important that we talk about how we safely approach high voltage to make sure that we can do this safely.
Is it okay that I have metal plates in my head?
First rule is don't touch it with two hands. Second rule is don't put your head in it.
I just won't touch it with my head. I think I can avoid that, yeah.
The fun thing about this, the like wrinkle in all of this, is David, he's not allowed to touch anything. So David No Hands is gonna instruct us on how to build a fusion device.
I feel like this mostly has to do with our ego and no practical.
Yeah, we're gonna build it. We just need David to tell us how.
He's the brain, we're the hands.
Yes, I like that.
This is gonna be a workout.
So now what is that? We're gonna take that chamber and we're gonna rotate the turbo pump.
Okay, how does that look?
I think it looks great, but I also don't know what I'm doing.
At this point, we should put on gloves.
What is this device called?
George.
We're building a Farnsworth fuser. It's a very compact, small device to do some amount of fusion. You're building a vacuum chamber. All fusion devices have this. A stellarator type fusion has a really twisty, turny one. Helion's devices are cylindrical. A tokamak has more of a donut. It's got a D-shaped cross section.
So I know that in order to do fusion, we're confining plasma. And I know that the sun does this with gravity, gravitational confinement. Then two sort of broad categories of how humans do this are magnetic confinement and inertial confinement. Magnetic confinement uses magnets to confine plasma, and one kind of inertial confinement is using lasers to push the plasma close together and then things fuse. So my question is, what method is this device using?
This one uses something called electrostatic inertial confinement. In this case, we're going to take two deuteriums, which is a neutron and a proton, and they fuse together to form helium-4, which has two protons and two neutrons, this bigger molecule that then is really hot. And that's how we take the energy out of that particle. We do it in a spherical way, where the ions stream in from all angles to a center core. And as they collide, they fuse. And each of those fusion reactions will produce tremendously more energy than it took to actually fuse them together. The challenge with that is that on a particle accelerator, you only take one or a packet of a couple hundred. And so yes, you can make fusion, but you can't make enough to counteract all the energy you spent on the electronics to make that thing happen.
So just to repeat this back to you, the challenge that we're having with fusion right now, we can get an enormous amount of energy out of the actual atomic reaction, mm-hmm. but we are having trouble getting more total electricity out of the system that we create to do it in the first place.
That's right.
Awesome. Okay, I understand the problem. This is deuterium. We are just pros at this. I shouldn't say that. But
let's be humble for a little bit longer. I'll let you know when we can stop being humble.
Thank you.
Like, what are we gonna do next time we hang out to top this?
Are you gonna be disappointed if next time I come over, we just
have coffee? Yeah.
How do we know when fusion is happening in the middle? Like, what are we looking for at that moment?
Yeah, so what we're looking for is a couple of things. Mostly what we do is we know how hot it is, we know how much energy all those particles have, and when they come together, they collide, and so we know that they must be doing fusion.
Why is it pink?
The color that you see is actually not pink at all. It's totally not pink. It looks pink. It's blue and red at the same time. There's a blue photon and a bright red photon. And when your eye sees those two photons together, it looks like that pink color. You get that fuchsia color. That is the deuterium plasma being made.
Nope.
these good sounds?
These are all good sounds, all good.
Now what?
So now we're gonna plug in that roughing pump.
Okay. Ah. Yeah, good?
Yep, that's good.
Okay.
So the next step is you can open that and it'll suck the air out of the two pumps. Now you can open that. But it looks like it's a little open already. Ah, so there you go. As she tightens those, you can see that it's starting to come down a lot faster.
Nice.
So that was probably leaking a little bit.
All right, so now we have pumped all of the air out, right?
Yeah, we're ready. We can hook up the fusion fuel and the fusion power supplies and start to do fusion.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Awesome. Let's do it.
What's the first step?
Fusion fuel.
Got my fusion fuel here. I'll show you.
Oh.
Deuterium. Why did the sound change?
We lost a breaker. Here, let me turn the breaker back on.
Should
we? That was a bad sound. We popped the fuse on that.
Yeah.
And then that shut all the power down, and then it started leaking air in. We're gonna let it come back down.
Unplug everything and plug it in straight there.
Okay.
We popped a fuse, so the air that we'd sucked out of the chamber where we want to do the fusion all rushed back in. And you can't do fusion with a bunch of air molecules in there. So we shut everything down, we rerouted the pumps, and we vacuumed the air back out again.
I'm so scared of it, or I feel like I'm like all skittish and I'm like ready to bounce.
Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna start introducing the fuel into the chamber. We're just gonna turn it slowly so we get to used to what it's gonna sound like.
I did those. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Okay, open slowly.
Mm-hmm. And you can close it. And then it should, now it's pumping the gas back out. So a lot of fusion is listening to the machine.
Yeah.
Next.
All right.
We need to get out the power supply.
Now begins the do not die section.
But as soon as the plasma starts, it'll start to flow current. So there's enough voltage to start the plasma, but then once it starts going, we keep the current low so it doesn't have too much. Okay, we're gonna test this right now. High voltage is on, ready? We're at 1,000 volts.
Ooh.
There's 2,000 volts, 3,000 volts, 4,000 volts, 6,000 volts. Okay.
To open.
Mm-hmm. To
really open. Slowly.
Really slowly.
With one hand.
With one hand.
I heard something.
Slower than that, still, but really slow.
My heart is beating so
really
fast.
Slow.
Ah! Something out of happening! Ah! It's all sci-fi stuff.
Okay, now close it.
Close it to the right. Okay, to the right.
Am I in the way?
Yeah,
Oh, now it died. What happened? Why did it die?
So we went all the way up in pressure to where there was enough particles to make a plasma. And then just to show it, we then came all the way back down.
Why didn't we stay?
So you're gonna have to get more fine on your gas control.
Okay.
Like really fine. High voltage on. Okay. Gas, just a little bit of gas. Really slow. Gas is coming up, it's lit. Now turn to the right, slow it down. Real slow.
Oh my God, Cleo, you gotta look at this thing. It looks unlike anything I've ever seen.
There you go, now turn to the right slow. Oh, you're dialing really, switch the gauge around, and then I would adjust the gas pressure.
Okay. So the problem that we were having before was that I was too clammy hands on the gauge there, so I was causing it to sort of jump around and not have the right amount of all of the things it needed for the right amount of time. We've swapped some things around to make it easier to control now, and we're gonna try it again. Because the key is we have to get it up to the right temperature for long enough to know that we actually did fusion.
This valve's harder than, yep.
Sorry. Wait, it was there! It's gone now.
Sorry, we scared you. Quiet.
Nice core and a jet, a single jet with a single pinch. And so what you're really seeing here is the ions, those charged particles that are floating around that haze, are getting focused in and blasting in. It's not actually coming out, it's going in.
Oh.
Those ions are coming in to the core. And as they come through and they hit things, they ionize and form more plasma.
There's two kind of like pinch points on the beam. Like there's another
thinner point. Oh, wow.
Wow, this is pretty awesome.
It is pretty awesome.
So at this point, we're now at the right densities and pressures and voltage, so we should be creating fusion right now.
Is it happening?
It's happening right now.
Yeah, oh my gosh.
And probably in those pinch points and a little bit in the core too.
What's happening as it evolves?
So now it's starting to run out of gas. There's not enough ions around to actually drag in and collide with the background gas.
This is amazing. Oh my God.
And then eventually the gas will decay enough that there won't be enough to even sustain a plasma at all. So right now we have a core and this like tiny little jet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I wonder if like two generations down, this is gonna be the equivalent of like watching your like washing machine go, where you're like, oh my God, that's so cool.
Yay!
Hot tip, if your friends ever like, hey, can we do fusion in your garage? Say yes.
Be the crazy friend that says yes.
Be the even crazier friend that asks.
Wait, so now can we say we did fusion?
Yes, you can say that.
Yes!
At that accelerating voltage and pure deuterium, at this pressure, there was fusion.
In my workshop.
We did fusion in Simone's workshop.
So crazy. What the fusion?
What the fusion?
So we've done all of this. We've built this device. We've done fusion in Simone's workshop. Like, how should people understand what we did here in comparison to what companies like yours and government projects are trying to do with nuclear fusion, and like how this might get them electricity sometime in the future?
No, it's a great question. So we built a fuser today, but this is not a commercial electricity system. Commercial electricity systems are going to be larger, they're going to be more complex. But what we are seeing is that the rate of progress of the technology is such that now private companies, governments are now building systems that do commercial levels of fusion already. And so now it's a matter of us building systems and getting them on the grid as fast as possible. What I believe, and Helion believes, is that we are close enough to start thinking about having electricity on the grid from fusion in our lifetimes. And I want it much sooner than that.
Huge if true. Thanks, Simone, for lending us your workshop. Thank you for coming. Like, thank you to the team at Helion.
We are the individual atoms, and we come, and we fuse, and then we are one atom. Somebody stop us.